Hello and welcome to the UltraServers YouTube channel. Today we'll be teaching you how to cross-play between Bedrock and Java Edition servers. This tutorial is a bit complex, so let's get on with the video. First thing you will need to do is make your way to the Geyser MC download page and download both Geyser and Floodgate. Once you have done that, you can make your way to your UltraServers inventory and click Manage on the server you'd like to set up on. Once you have done that, just make your way over to the Settings tab and make sure that you have either a Paper, Purpur, or Spigot server type installed. But for this, we recommend using a Purpur server. Next, just go to the File Manager, enter the plugins folder here, and just upload both of the files that you have just downloaded. There we go, the Geyser upload was successful, so now we can go ahead and do the Floodgate file. So the next thing you want to do is stop your server and then start it right back up again. This just ensures that the files can create and input themselves correctly. Next, you want to go to the server.properties file found in the file manager and click Control Left and search for the online mode option. You want to make sure this is set to true so people on Bedrock can actually join the server. Once editing this value, make sure to save the file by clicking the top right button. Next, you want to make your way over to the Ports tab and click Add Port button. So, as we can see here, a new port has been created and you just want to go ahead and copy these numbers here under the port address and just copy that. Now move back over to the File Manager. Go into the Plugins folder, look for the Geyser Spigot folder, and then open the config.yml. And then at the top here where we see the port section, you just want to paste in what you just copied. Make sure there is a space after the colon, otherwise it won't register correctly. So next, save the file, and once that is saved, restart your server one more time. Now all you have to do is give the new port an IP address to the Bedrock player and use the primary port and the normal IP for Java players. With that done, you should be able to crossplay successfully. And that is all we have for you in this video. So thank you for watching. We hope this worked out correctly for you and we'll see you in the next video. Bye!